Hey people, what is up? I just got this package in the mail. I ordered this thing Friday, okay, and it got here Monday, which is why I like priority mail. It's fast, dependable, and they do it on Saturday. Anyway, what's in this box is a result of my boy iSpy, okay? I watched one of his videos and I kind of caught the bug and I was like, okay, sign me up. So, why don't we just bite into it and see what it tastes like, shall we? Got my black bladed pika. And let's check it out. What is that? Maxpedition EDC pocket organizer thingy. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna check this thing out, give some initial impressions. Got the camera kind of zoomed up here, but you know, you can get a nice close-up of it. I like how they did the lanyards, or the zipper pulls rather, very reminiscent on how I did them. I didn't even know this, by the way. I wasn't even paying attention when I was looking on the website, but that's how I did them on my Canon bag. Pretty cool, same color. Looks like they probably go pretty good with it. All right. Just looking it at, or looking it over here, checking it out. Good stretchy. Alright, how about we load this bad boy up and see what it can do. And then I'm going to cut this video and I'll come back when it's loaded up and tell you about it, what I think about it. Okay, here is my Maxpedition Super Tactical EDC baggy thing. And you know, you can see I got it loaded up real fat, which is a very good, very, very good attribute of these Maxpedition bags, in my opinion. From what I've seen, you can load them up fat and a zipper still pulls perfectly. I mean, you know, you just look at that, you know. So most bags, that's actually a hard feat to accomplish, but I'll get into that in just a second. I got my issue of Blue Press today, and I don't know how many of you actually, you know, get Blue Press, but you know, this is my issue from June 2010, okay? That's Kathy Rankin, and she is smoking. All right, I showed this in a video, you know, a past video. And then I got the July issue, okay? This is hot. And then, you know, I'm like, oh, okay, whatever, doable. And then I got the August issue today, and oh yeah, check that out. Is that not hotness right there? I mean, you know, I know Blue Press always puts a gun in the photo, but it took me like 4 minutes to realize there was a gun in this photo. And I wasn't looking at that gun. You know what guns I was looking at. Either way, I'm kind of disappointed with the EDC bag. My issue of Blue Press does not fit in there, you know. And I guess I could fold her in half and put it in there, but you know, I'd only fold her in half if I met her in person, so either way.
Ooh, baby.
Okay, now I'm just being disrespectful. Where was I? I actually have a flag patch, and since they didn't have the color I wanted, I got a gray one, which actually matches with the lettering here, and you know, it's got the kind of shiny gray, which I happen to like, so green and gray, fine with me. Not real big deal. And like my buddy iSpy did, I'm going to throw me something behind there. I don't know what yet, you know, but that's a pretty damn good idea. I like that idea. So, we'll do that. Now, let's check it out. First of all, as I mentioned, zippers open perfectly. I mean, it's stuffed fat, and the zipper is just perfectly open, okay, all the way. So, let's check out what we got inside here. All right. Now, first of all, over here, I got a pin. Couple of pins. This is my good Parker pin. okay? Really good stainless steel, aluminum, all that shit. Then I got this little Uniball Super Ink, which these are really, really badass pens in my opinion. I've used these forever, and these write really good, so I like those. Of course, I got my stainless steel Sharpie, which also doubles as an impact weapon if you ask me, because this thing is stout. And a couple of drivers here. I got a Husky brand, you know, flathead Phillips. Then I got a Torx. I got all kind of Torx bits in the back down here. If you don't know what these are badass little tools. Okay. Got these at like Home Depot. Back here we got my Gerber clutch. And I'm not going to talk about all this stuff too much because, you know, y'all have seen my videos. Y'all see what these are. Gerber clutch is in there. Back here I got my Prion. And on this little tab that holds something right there, pull that out. I actually have a little pill container that, when populated, can hold my headache medicine because I get headaches. You know, I've been getting migraines since I was like, you know, 5 years old. So, you know, they piss me off too. They make me angry. I got my little Gerber Artifact pry bar dilly with the X-Acto blade in it. There's my Inova X1. Okay, I got two flashlights, yes. And then I carry a third one, which is my little, you know, Phoenix LDO1. Because, you know what they say, 3 is 2, 2 is 1, 1 is none. So redundancy is a good thing in my opinion, so you might see a little bit of it. Here's my, what the fuck is that called, man? I got that one tethered, you see. Micra. No shit, man. Leatherman Micra. I got that tethered to this little S-beaner thingy because these are very useful, as I've said. And, you know, it don't really need to be tethered on there because these hold really well. But, you know, I got it. That's what it is. Lighter, because you never know when you might need to set some shit on fire. Let's see. A screwdriver, another one. Once again, redundancy is good. You know, just a little cheap Stanley screwdriver. Works really nice, in my opinion. Gives you a little bit bigger Phillips head and flathead option than the other one did. This one right here. So, what else do we have? We have a Griptilian, because you never know when you might need a Griptilian. That's like the Spyderco Endura of Benchmade, in my opinion. Something else. I'm forgetting shit. Down here somewhere, I got some paracord. I'm not going to pull it all out, but there's some paracord, probably about maybe 10 feet stuck in there, 20 feet, whatever. I don't know, 15 feet in there somewhere. Could be useful. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, let me stick these guys back on in there and show you how we close it. You know, I'm just showing y'all what's going on with it. Y'all seen these before, I'm sure. But they got really thick nylon. I mean, you know, it is like some stout stuff. You gotta feel it to appreciate it. When I was watching iSpy's video on the Maxpedition little notebook case that he got, it looked good. I mean, the video looked good, or the case in the video looked good, and I was really impressed by the way it looked. I get it at home, you know, I get this one. It's a little bit different, but I get it in the house, and I start messing with it, and man, they are built. I am impressed. You know, so. And then, like, when you get your zipper, you know, it's fat. It is, like, jammed in there fat. And I can put more crap in there, too. And, you know, it just closes up smoothly. See that? And I... Very good. I'm impressed. Got your little carry handle and your little, you know, you can attach this to some webbing or whatever if you want to. Maybe you could throw some extra stuff back there, like if you had another, you know, whatever, pin, whatever you want to do, knife, whatever. You could actually hook this through your belt if you wanted and, you know, have this, like, accessible on the belt. You could hook this, your belt, you know, through this and let it hang. You know, all kind of options. It's just a very good little pack. I paid, like, $20 for it. Damn well worth every penny of that, in my opinion. You know? So, I recommend them. And, iSpy, thank you, bro. I'm glad you influenced this one because I am liking it, man. I'm digging it. So, there it is. Life's short. Stay sharp.